That should be enough. To make all the touch of cold that I'll need. Trying to help the buck ascend the mountain to find a crystal flower. Unbeknownst to him, I think that the stag is preventing the buck from taking its rightful place as the new heir. But in order to get this crystal flower, we have to get up the mountain. But there's trappers blocking the way. I've returned, my dear friend. My plan is ready. I think everything will be fine. No need to worry. I will have these trappers taken care of. No time. Ah, I only needed one. There were so many trappers up here, I was worried I'd need a lot more. But I have forgotten the... Oops, I've forgotten the potent ability of this spell. Glance at the buck hiding safely behind a tree. At the far side of the camp, making a raven's call, you signal him to join you. The buck picks his way through the frozen trappers. Are they going to be okay? They might catch a case of the sniffles. Nothing a nice warm bowl of soup won't fix. Come along now. We're still a ways away from the mountain peak. I think I know a way up. I'll meet you ahead. Come join me when you're ready. Okay. Frozen mountain trappers. If you've got hair, fur, or pelts, you better hide your hide. What's this? Preserved fish. Fish well prepared to weather what may come. I see a chest. I'll just help myself to what you have inside. Fish and some frozen treats. Oh. Mountain goats. A shaggier cousin of the familiar goat. It's looking for something to climb on. These spicy peppers will keep me warm on my journey up the mountain. Oh. Small geyser. A pressure so built up as to penetrate the ancient stone of the mountain. These are nice and warm. Oh, there you are. Before you stands a looming rock face. Not even the most determined climber could hope to scale it. I thought you said you knew a way up to the peak. Well, you see, this is the Great Geyser. When the air is cold enough, the water erupting from it freezes solid. I thought it might give us something to climb up, You look into the dry crater at the bottom of the sheer cliff. I don't see much erupting happening down there. It's been dormant for a few seasons now. I kind of hope we'd get lucky. I don't trust any luck that I don't make myself. You take a moment to ponder your situation. And eye the small geysers nearby, frequently spewing steam up into the frosty air. I suppose these other waterspouts all draw from the same underground source. I think you're right. They started popping up shortly after the great geyser fell silent. Then I wager if we plug them up, we'll be able to make a big one blow its top again. Plug them with what? You turn your attention to the bleeding mountain goats digging for lichen nearby. Oh, are we gonna stuff the mountain goats in them? Those frosty beasts look to be about the right diameter. Maybe I can coax some of them into position. Okay. Poor goats. Let's try. Goat perch. What do I need for a goat perch? Oh, I'm gonna need a lot of, cobblestone, some magic paste, and shiny lures. Okay, I think I'll need to head back to the marketplace to acquire some more of these items. Well, I've come up with a plan, but again, I'm lacking some items required. You should be safe up here now. If not, just in case the trappers wake up, keep this with you. I shall return, maybe another hour. Feel free to head back to the castle if you would rather stay there, but these geysers are pretty warm. Perhaps while we're there, we can work on finishing this quest. I should have everything for the final effigy. The Magi Sharp XL. Did I make that yet? Yeah, I did. I have one in my inventory. Okay, let's head back to the marketplace. Collect some items to make some goat perches. And while we're there, finish off the hog quest. Where was that, where was it? Here it is. Through the rift. Okay, and the marketplace is just here. Kitty cats. Oh. I did pick up a fish. Should we make a cat treat? Let's see. Find that recipe in my grimoire. Here it is. I would need one more goat's milk. cow milk. I have enough to make 4 cat treats, though. Okay. Now, let's, where is the... this, right here, chopping block. Just think of how much more brutal you could be with a brand new sharpener. Such as this one. The sow slowly grinds the blade of her clever cleaver across the new whetstone, sending flecks of rust flying. She plucks a hair from her own chin and tests the keenness of the edge by splitting it in half. Oh, not bad at all. Go on, take this old stone and throw it in the trash bin. Is this just an old brick? No wonder she didn't sharpen anything. And while I'm here, I'm going to collect some bricks. Cobblestones. Not bricks. Cobblestones. Or the goat perch. Need 8. And there were, what, 3 geysers? So I'm going to need a lot of these cobblestones. And also, I think for the magic paste, do I need milk? I do. Okay, we'll need to collect some milk while we're here. I did make a bunch of pots recently. But I think there's a cow just up here. Yes. Let me check that again. Magic paste. I've got 1. So I'll have enough for... how much magic paste? Only 1. Okay. So I need... 3... And I'm also going to make some cat treats while I'm here. Feed the kitty cats. Oops. So... I can always make more empty jars. Gonna milk this cow dry. Sorry, girl. That's a good girl. You rest up now. Okay. Magic paste. Make the cat treats. Can make 4. Leaves me 3 milk. I think that's actually perfect. Let's hope that there wasn't a 4th geyser that I didn't notice. Okay. Shiny lures I can also get here. I'm gonna need a couple more of the fireflies from the forest. Can get that later. Would also need wicker work. Okay, the effigy should be ready. This ham is almost ready for dinner. It just needs one more helping of soul food. Something special from that brutish butcher will be the last ingredient I need. One whetstone, or simply a brick. Toss the old brick into the effigy's ravenous maw, and it cracks into dust within moments. With its final meal of bricks, the porcine simulacrum swells to monstrous proportions. A rattling laugh chills your blood as the old man's spirit looks upon your work. Haha, what a proper beggar's feast this is. I thank you for the kind gesture, but I still don't see how this will bring justice to those wretched swine. Just you wait. I have to fire up the barbecue first. A spark is all I need. Probably a cinder box. I have enough to make just one. Striking a spark into the pit, you set the tinder alight. You take a step back, watching the orange flames leap high into the air. The porcine effigy blackens as you tend the fire and fuss over the coals. A succulent aroma begins to waft on the wind. The old man licks his translucent lips hungrily. I swear, I could almost smell a delicious roast. Ah, if only it were real. Over the sound of crackling logs, you hear a crowd of footsteps come padding down the road towards the cooking pit. Over here. I knew I smelled something good. It's the others, my friends. You've come back. A ghost! No, wait. Is that Old Man McCaw? Say it ain't so, old-timer. When you never showed up for the morning headcount, we all feared the worst. It's true, I ended up as pig food. Can't you believe that? I worried you would all face the same fate as me. However, did you escape the hog farm? It was the strangest thing. The swine sisters started complaining about the weather being too hot, even though it's pretty chilly, if you ask me. All of a sudden, they bolted out into the woods, squealing all the way. Left the gate wide open and everything. Then we smelled something delightful on the breeze and couldn't resist. It's been so long since we've had anything other than pig slop. Gosh, that smells so good. Is it barbecue? Where did you get all that food? In place of the brick, sticks, and straw, the porcine effigy has split into a mountain of delectable, sizzling meats. Ham, sausages, bacon, it's all looks so delicious. What a wonder, it's truly a feast, thank you. What did I tell you? Enjoy yourself for a little while longer, and be at peace. the starving crowd happily helps themselves to the feast, cheering, laughing, and praising the old man's name. You see something twinkle amongst the cooling coals of the cooking pit. Warm to the touch, you pick out a piece of greasy gristle from the soot. On closer inspection, it appears to be three separate chunks. One fat piece, one long piece, and one small piece. The souls of the pigs. The hog. Quest completed. Oh, look at them. Enjoying their feast. How wonderful. Thank you for this feast. You're welcome. I do hope you find the rest that you so deserve.